A smart car did that. A smart car. Look. Yeah, a smart car did that. That's kind of impressive, actually. By the way, that's me. Yes, I'm dead, and this is where I'm starting the story from. Groundbreaking.
This shit's straight out of an art film, right? Speaking of films, how do I continue my story without a bunch of exposition? I mean, I'm a film student, so no matter what I do, people are gonna hate it. Okay, I'm not actually a film student yet. Not yet, as in it's going to happen. Okay, I mean, I'm dead, so nothing's happening to me other than a quick visit to the morgue, maybe a wake. A closed casket wake, and then I'm buried into the ground and forgotten about, just to decompose and be eaten by bacteria for the rest of the existence of my physical body. Can't I just narrate the plot to you? I mean, Martin Scorsese does it in all of his movies, and people love jerking off to those. Fuck, whatever. Most people describe after being hit by a car that the pain doesn't register immediately. Someone even said it was like the world was all chaotic, that noise and light moved in a blur. Well, for me, it was blinding light and then immediate darkness. If I told my pastor this, he'd...
Film school? Are you retarded?
What the f- Call an ambulance! You just stumbled across a kid who'd been hit by a car. I mean, for all you know, he could still be alive and losing his life.
Well, yeah, but... Are we really losing anything here?
If I told my pastor this, he'd say that it's God coming to collect the soul he's due. But no, it was just the headlights blinding me before the impact of the car hit me so hard it cracked my neck and I died almost immediately. That's a huge relief for me, though, because if God did exist, then I'd be fucked.
This is before the crash, for all you extra perceptive people. Do you need something?
Just making sure you're not watching porn.
In the kitchen.
Did that art school you applied to get back to you?
Yeah, I got the letter right here.
And?
I haven't opened it yet.
It's art school. You probably got it.
Do you think I can get like a shred of suspense, please?
Are you getting into film school, not Harvard?
You know, Dad, Tarantino didn't go to Harvard, and look where he is now.
He also didn't go to film school.
He wasn't always so subtle with his emotions in any given situation, but that's okay. This isn't some story about how my dad doesn't show enough appreciation for my life choices. He's perfectly happy with whatever I do.
I wouldn't call it happy. It's more content.
My goodness, Dad.
What? You want me to shower you with unconditional love to the point you have to rely on my income till you're 30? I mean, I'm still doing your laundry.
No. Just like a good job every once in a while, you know?
Yeah, good job for getting into art school.
I haven't opened it yet.
You probably got in.
Is this emotional abuse? Whatever. No. Just stay there.
I'll do the transition.
That's my friend Corey. I know him on a level I've never known anyone else. I can't emphasize this enough, actually. We know each other very closely.
Why are you saying it like that? You're not gay.
He is, though.
Just half gay.
Mm.
Leaning towards women.
Although rare, we have these very deep and personal conversations when we're alone. I know, it's crazy. The best way to get to know someone is talking to them. During these conversations, we go over all sorts of things like existential questions, political beliefs, personal stories, and what was it this time?
Well, you brought us here for a reason. Specifically to get a theme across.
I don't get it. There's a theme.
We were talking about your future.
Oh, shit, right.
Oh, you done with that? See, I don't see a problem with it. Yes, it's film school. And yes, if you fail, you may have to work as a barista at Starbucks until you're about 57 in order to pay off just half your student debt, if you're lucky.
Go America.
But you're taking a gamble with your life. A gamble most people are too afraid to take. And that's an accomplishment in itself, man.
But if I fail, and let's be honest, the odds aren't in my favor, I fail hard. There's no middle ground in this career path.
Well, that's somewhat true. You either fail becoming a filmmaker or you succeed.
Mm-hmm.
But being successful doesn't always mean being commercially successful.
But I want to be known as one of the greats, and that usually coincides with commercial success.
Have you ever heard of Lars von Trier?
No, as a filmmaker, I've never heard of Lars von Trier. Trier?
There you go. Him existing is proof that you can still be great without everyone knowing who you are.
He's just one example. A very specific example. I never said it's not possible. I'm just saying it's not likely.
As unlikely as it is to succeed in the first place. Didn't Lars von Trier go to film school?
Right. He did.
You ever hear back from that school?
I got a letter.
You carried it around with you. And you haven't opened. Okay.
This is the biggest question I keep asking myself. What do I do if I know what I want to do, but I just don't know how to get there?
But does getting there really involve education on a subject that can't be taught? $100,000 deficit, a few hundred miles away from home, and constantly being surrounded by people who think they know what they're doing. Artificial is really annoying. He thinks that just because he writes all the time, he'll somehow make it big when he finally gets a chance to move out to Hollywood. He's unaware of this thing called statistical probability. Hello.
Hey, can I come over?
I'm a bit busy.
Can I please come over?
I'm a bit busy.
Look, you're not busy.
What? How? How long were you standing there?
Let's just put it this way. You got good taste.
What the fuck do you want?
Please?
How long will this take?
Oh, it's only like a few pages. It shouldn't take too long. So, what do you think?
It's all right.
No. Roast me. Tell me what you really think.
Well, your characters keep breaking the fourth wall and addressing the audience without establishing a set of rules for the universe. You just assume the audience knows what you're referring to when you talk to them. Also, what's with the pretentious character backstories? Your main character's an art student dealing with the hardships of reality. Please, I've seen that shit a million times before. Your comedic timing is off, your characters are so blandly written it's easy enough for me to put them into categories. There's way too many monologues, you keep insulting certain groups of people. There's no thematic focus, and on top of that, you haven't even given your main character a name. I have a feeling you don't know what you're doing.
You're a garbage person.
Whoa.
Hey, that's not fair.
But your assessment of my script was?
You asked me to be honest.
Fine. Then it's my turn to be honest. I think your assessment of other filmmakers comes from a place of insecurity. You think that in the competitive field of filmmaking, there's only so many open spots for emerging talent. You don't see other filmmakers as creative allies. No, you see them as aggressive competition. I mean, everyone's out to get you, right? It's obvious that's the case with your assessment. It doesn't matter what other up-and-coming filmmakers make. No matter how genius it is, no matter how genius it might be, you'd still tell them it sucks because somehow that makes your opportunity to succeed just a little bit bigger. You know what? From the bottom of my heart, heed my advice. Be wary of the foot you step on today because it might be attached to the ass you have to kiss tomorrow.
No. No, everything you just said was wrong. What the fuck? Oh, everything you just said was stupid and it was wrong. Look, you're a terrible writer. And that's okay. Me telling you what's objectively wrong with your script should help you revise it properly. I swear to God.
Bitch!
Oh, fuck you!
You know, resorting to violence just shows you're incapable of using words. No wonder why your script sucks shit! Fucking idiot. Broke my fucking statue. Cut.
Oh my God. Perfect. What a generic way to force a sequence of events to occur.
You know, this is around the point where I begin to contemplate the reality of this situation. Even if I do get into film school, then what? I move halfway across the country to attend fucking art school? What the hell am I doing?
Some weird kid told me about this quantum theory called Schrodinger's cat, coined by a physicist named Erwin Schrodinger. In its most basic description, it means that the outcome of something isn't determined until someone observes it. Until then, both possibilities occur. So what he's saying is that if I don't open this letter, I've both gotten into film school and got rejected. That's stupid. I either got in or I didn't. Not both.
Well, shit. What was the point of all this? Well, I guess I'm dead now, so there was no point. What a waste of time.